Good morning, children. Welcome back to the English grammar class. So already you have received one or two grammar videos, and I hope this is the third session of English grammar for you. You know that grammar is an essential part of language. Without using proper grammar, no languages can be satisfied. So to write proper English or to speak, we want to understand grammar. So children, what is the spelling of grammar? It is G-R-A-M-M-A-R. Grammar. It is not grammar. It is grammar. Let's see what we are going to learn today. Children, you have already learned about parts of speech like noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjectives, prepositions, all that you have learned under parts of speech. So today we are going to learn about pronouns. So let's see what is a pronoun. A pronoun is a part of speech that is used in place of a noun. You know what is a noun? Noun is a naming word. What is noun? Noun is a naming word. So, the word that we use in place of a noun, instead of a noun, that is known as pronoun. For example, Raju is studying in 6th standard. Here the subject or the noun is Raju. Raju is studying in 6th standard. So instead of Raju, we can use the word he. And we say that he is very brilliant. So listen, children. The sentence what is given is, Raju is studying in 6th standard. Raju is very brilliant. If you use or if you go on saying Raju, Raju in all the sentences, it is boring. So to avoid that, we use pronoun in place of that noun. Instead of Raju, from the second sentence onwards, we can use the word he. Here, he is the pronoun. Understood, children? So, pronoun is a word that is used in place of a noun. Then, there are different types of pronouns. All the types of pronouns you might be studied in your lower classes. So, let's revise once again. Personal pronoun. Personal pronoun that is used in place of people or things. Personal, you know, it indicates a person. Personal pronoun. So, the pronoun which is used in place of the name of people or things is known as what? A personal pronoun. For example, you can meet me tomorrow. The sentence is, you can meet me tomorrow. So here, you is a person, me is a person. Okay, so both are indicated by pronouns. Now, the second type of pronoun, that is possessive pronoun. Possessive pronoun is a pronoun that shows possession, that is ownership. If I say This is my pen. That shows that this pen belongs to me, not for anybody else. So that is what a possession. So a possessive pronoun shows the possession. For example, this book is yours. So when we say this book is yours, or this book is mine, or this book is his, all that shows that book belonged to that particular person. So that is what possessive pronoun. The next one is demonstrative pronoun. What is demonstrative pronoun? It is used to point to nouns. Demonstrative pronouns are the pronouns that are used to point to nouns. Let's see an example. This is a nice surprise. So, some surprise is there. Okay, that surprise is the noun here. So, this is a nice surprise. So, the word this shows about the surprise. So, that is why it is called demonstrative pronoun. Next, interrogative pronoun. So, the next type of pronoun is interrogative pronoun. Interrogative pronoun is used to ask questions. You know, interrogative means questions. Interrogative is nothing but questions. So, to ask questions, we use interrogative pronoun. Let's see an example. Whose book is lying on the mat? So, when we ask, whose book is lying on the mat? So, that's a question. We use the word whose. Understood, children? So, the last type what we are going to learn now is reflexive pronoun. What is that? Reflexive pronoun. So, what is reflexive pronoun? Reflexive pronoun is used when the subject and object of a sentence refer to the same person. Subject as well as the object indicate the same person. Such pronouns are called reflexive pronouns. We use it as a self forms. The other name for reflexive pronoun is self forms. I enjoyed myself. So, it's a reflexive pronoun is what? Myself. He enjoyed himself. Or she enjoyed herself. You enjoyed yourself. So this is what reflexive pronoun. Here we are going to learn about two more pronouns, two more types of pronouns. Okay. So the next one is emphatic pronoun. Pronoun. See, emphatic pronouns are used for emphasis. What is emphasis? We are giving importance to something and saying that is called what? Emphasis. For example, my father himself made this toolbox. So, when we say my father himself made this toolbox, it is emphatic pronoun. That is, the word himself emphasizes my father. The pronoun himself emphasizes my father. So, it is called what? A emphatic pronoun. And next is a relative pronoun. What is that? A relative pronoun. It relates a noun to a group of words that follow. A relative pronoun relates a noun to a group of words that follow. A And they join sentences. So relative pronouns join two sentences. For example, we use the words who, whom, whose, which, that. All these are used to join sentences or parts of sentences. These are called what? Relative pronouns. So now totally we have learned about 7 types of pronouns. Now the first pronoun what we have learned is personal pronoun. So the pronoun which indicate a person or a thing, that is known as what? Personal pronoun. So now let us see which are the different personal pronouns. We can divide the personal pronouns into two groups, that is subject pronoun and object pronouns. Personal pronouns can be divided into two groups, that is subject pronouns and object pronouns. What are subject pronouns? Personal pronouns that come in place of the subject in a sentence is called subject pronoun. So the pronoun that we use in place of a subject in a sentence is known as what? Subject pronoun. So obviously you know what is object pronoun. It's a pronoun that is used in place of the object. So the pronoun which is used in place of subject is called subject pronoun, and that which used in place of an object is known as object pronoun. Now let us see which are the subject pronouns and its object pronouns. So we classified the pronouns into first person, second person, third person. Okay, all the pronouns have been classified into first person, second person, and third person. So in the first person, I is the subject pronoun in first person. I is the subject pronoun in the first person. So this object pronoun is me. What's the object pronoun of that? Me. So if we want to say ourselves, about ourselves, we have to use the subject pronoun as I and the object pronoun as me. My father brought me a new pen. So that is, there the me is object pronoun. I'm going to play. That I is the subject pronoun. Next. The second person, that is you, its object pronoun is also you. And the third person is he, she, etc. He, we, you know third person we you can say, or they we can say. These are all what are the third person subject pronoun. And its object pronoun is as, them, etc. Understood? He is a singular, I is singular, we plural, they plural. Okay, and you we can use both as a singular and a plural. So this is what subject pronoun and object pronoun. So subject pronouns are the pronouns that we use in place of a subject. And the object pronouns are the pronouns that we use in place of object in a sentence. Children, I hope you understood this topic. Today we have learned about the different types of pronouns. So first we have learned what is a pronoun, and which are the different types of pronouns, and what is subject pronoun and what is object pronoun. So how can we use the pronouns as a subject and as an object? This is what we have learned at the end. I hope you understood all these topics. This is a small topic. Go through this 2-3 times and make it thorough. Thank you.